few more interesting questions. These questions are also asked as conceptual questions. So first question, and then five questions are four, having four parts. And in question number five, in each diagram we have to find equivalent or net resistance on the circuit. So let's begin with question number four. Solution 4. N resistance, N number of identical resistance are in series gives out X, in parallel gives out Y. So let each resistance is equal to R. So in series, X is equal to R plus R n times. So X is equal to n R. In parallel, Y is equal to n over R. We can use 1 over R, 1 over R, n over R. So that's how you can go ahead now. You want to find relation between n, and best way is to multiply. Multiply 1 and 2. So X into Y is equal to n square. This is the relation. Question number 5, solution part A. Is an identical, systematic or symmetric network. You see, each 4 resistance block, 2 are up, 4 are down, and then like this there are 4 blocks. So better to calculate for one segment and then multiply with 4. So 1 and 1 are in series. So for one segment, first segment, in above arm there are 2 ohm, there is 2 ohm net resistance, down to it there is a 4 ohm resistance. And now they are in parallel, so R dash equivalent 1 over R dash is equal to 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4. That comes out R dash is equal to 4 over 3 ohm. Yes, LCM is 4, and then 2 plus 1, 4 by 3 ohm. Therefore, net resistance across AB is equal to 4 into R dash, that is 16 by 3 ohm. Question number 5B. It's also very interesting competitive examination question. R and R in series, then in parallel with R, then again in series, and then parallel with R. These all resistances are of 2R. Right. So simple, R in series, look at the diagram only, R and R series, 2R, then parallel with, I am talking about one part again, that is 1 over R dash is equal to 1 over 2R plus 1 over 2R is equal to, this implies R dash is equal to R. So So this will have R, then again R in series, then 2R in parallel, same situation, R and R, 2R, so again R, then again with this R and R, listen carefully, this is 2R, this is 2R in parallel, that comes out R, then this equivalent resistance of this is in series with R, R or R series mein 2R, 2R ho gaya, 2R is again parallel to 2R, so again same situation, 1 by 2R, 1 by answer is R there, R equals to R, then here also we have R, then again R is R in series, so 2R and 2R in parallel, so R again, then R and R in series, and then 2R in parallel, so the net equivalent resistance is R. This asked in NEET examination. Question number, part C of question number 5. Again in this question we see capacitor is placed. So I can say in the arm CD there will be no effective resistance. So C part, now what is left in the circuit, 2 ohm resistance here, 4 ohm resistance is here, these 2 ohm and 4 ohm are in series, and then 3 ohm resistance is here, 6 ohm resistance is here, these 3 ohm and 6 ohm are also in series, so upper arm resistance is 6 ohm, right? Lower arm resistance is 9 ohm. Now these two resistors are in parallel, so 1 over R dash or net value you can say is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2, that is 1 over 6 plus 1 over 9. LCM is 18, 3, 2. So R net is equal to 18 by 5. 18 by 5 means 3.6. D section is very interesting. This is called delta net. Three delta figures are there, 1, 2, 3. So the common delta point is this P. This is having zero potential. So you can always in delta network questions, you can remove this point from this joint. When you remove this, then your circuit diagram will look like this. Now I can mark resistances. These all arms are having resistances. Fine. One resistance is here. Another is here. One resistance is here. One resistance is here. Now it is easy to solve. These two are in series, so it is 2R. Then it is parallel in R. So R dash, 1 over R dash is equal to 1 over 2R plus 1 over R. LCM is 2R, 1 plus 2. So R dash is equal to 2 by 3R. This whole 2 by 3R are in series with 2 RR resistance. So R double dash will be R plus R dash, that is 2R plus 2R by 3, that comes out 8 by 3R. Is it clear? I am rubbing this because there is a less space left. 2R, sorry, 8/3R. Now in the lower arm, R and R resistances are of 2R. So these are in series. So the net is, and then this series arm is in parallel to this. So the net resistance 1 over R net is equal to 1 over 2R this R plus 1 over R double dash. So what is the answer? 1 over 2R plus 3 over 8R. 1 over Rn is equal to LCM is 8R and then 4 plus 3. So Rn is equal to 8/7R. That's how you can answer. Let's take one more question. Some more conceptual questions we can see. Suppose a child is doing Ohm's law experiment. He plots a graph between potential difference and current. Graph comes like this. This experiment and graph is plotted by say first boy A, and thereafter he left the circuit for another boy B to do it because teacher asked to do it. Then when second boy performs an experiment with the same arrangement, graph comes like this. What can be a plausible reason that even when apparatus is same, arrangement is same, the child B gets different graph than child A? Answer, what can happen there? If you look at a BI curve, slope of curve B, theta 2, and this is theta 1. Theta 2 is greater than theta 1. It means resistance in case of the B is coming resistance in case of A. Right? If it happens, then another question comes in the mind, why second time when with the same apparatus readings are taken by student B, resistance is coming more? Answer behind that is that first child A or child A has not disconnected the connections. Therefore, current continuously passes through the circuit. And as a result, when second boy comes and start doing experiment, the resistance of wire increases due to heating effect of current. As we know, when current is continuously passed through a wire gets heated up. So its temperature is increased, and we know the resistance of wire is directly proportional to the temperature. That's why the second graph B or resistance of VI curve calculated by boy B is higher. Let's see another question, which is a very simple question related with power. Suppose a bulb an electric bulb is marked with 100 volt, 110 volt, sorry, 220 volt and 100 watt. Normally it is marked on each and every bulb when you buy from this shop. This bulb is connected to 110 volt supply. Will there be a less or more power consumption? Good question. This is also very frequently asked in the examinations. So you have to justify it. How come, whether power consumed is less or more? Right? So let's see what, how do you calculate. What is not varying is resistance of the tungsten wire solution. So first calculate resistance is equal to V square over P. Power is equal to V square over R. So in the first case, 220 whole square over power is 100 watt. This is the resistance. I am not calculating because we have to use this value in the second case also. So power, this is first case power. Power in second case is, this you can say V1, V2 square over R. Resistance is not varying. Now voltage is 110 into 110 divided by R means 220 into 220 into 100, 225 watt. Isn't it interesting that electric bulb which is consuming 100 watt power, if you are connected to a 110 volt supply, the power consumption becomes 25 watt, which is nearly 1/4, not nearly, exactly 1/4, right? Let's see another question, one more question based on it. Question goes like, three identical resistors of resistance R. Three identical resistors of resistance R each. When connected in series to a DC source, dissipate power when connected in series with DC source consume power X, while in parallel with to the same source, while in parallel combination with same source they consume power equals to 1 connecting in parallel, calculate the power consumed. All right, so net resistance in series R plus R is equal to 3R. Therefore, power consumed P, say voltage is V square over R net. That is V square over 3R, and this is equal to X. Now calculate total resistance in parallel. Parallel combination. So 1 over R dash is equal to 1 over R plus 1 over R plus 1 over R, then R dash is equal to R by 3. Then you can easily calculate power consumed. P2 is equal to V square over R by 3. That is 3V square over R. Fine. And in series it is V square over 3R. So you can say this is 9x. So this is another wonderful question, which shows while you are connecting in series, the power consumed is less. While connect parallel, the power consumption is more.